the last couple of days did not go as planned. I'll be the first to admit it. Let me start from the beginning. That's me. If you're one for cliches, I guess that'd make me the brains of the operation. The man with the plan. George Clooney in that movie about those guys who knock over a casino.
Hey, you! Come on, give me your money! Give me your money!
Help!
Let's go!
Help.
Hurry up! Hurry up! Let's go!
Help!
You got anything else? No, be quiet! Be quiet! You got anything else?
Yeah,
let's
yeah.
Go. Give me it!
Help!
Anything
help!
Else? Keep
hey,
up.
Stop!
Oh, shit, you didn't see anything.
That's my brother, Zach. He's got a good head on him, but not an ounce of brains inside it. We've been working together on jobs since high school.
Hey, wait.
What?
How about if this, we go out for some pizza?
Now is not the time.
No, I know, but I'm just saying, like, after this, we always go and get some, like, nasty bar food, but how about we, you know, just...
Are you seriously talking about this right now? The guy's right around the corner, you're talking about food.
Yeah, I know, I just, you're right, just go, just... Wait.
What? Oh!
You know, make it look real.
This yours?
Awesome, man. Thanks. Hey, what happened to your face? Are you all right?
Yeah. Clipped me pretty good when I grabbed the wallet from him.
Well, thanks again, man.
No. Thank you.
But you know how the story goes. There's always that one big mistake. And that mistake's name is Dermot Gillian. Came from a wealthy family. Turned to crime either out of boredom or just from being a colossal asshole.
I've been more than generous with time, boys. $5,000 isn't pocket change, and I don't forget.
It's only been a month.
We borrowed the money as capital in a land acquisition con that we thought was a sure thing.
Sons of bitches! Get back here!
I wanna get out of here!
Sons of bitches, get out of here! I'll never catch you sons of bitches here again! I'll stick this so far up your ass!
It wasn't.
A month without $5,000. I'm a small business owner, and every red cent counts.
It's only $5,000. We can get that back.
Only $5,000? Have you ever dealt with money before? You boys own me interest. $10,000.
$10,000?
What the hell kind of interest rate
is
that?
We don't have that kind of money.
That's your problem, not mine.
You've done a lot of things, Dermot, but this...
Listen carefully to what I'm about to say. Here we play by the rules of the jungle, and only the strongest survive. And you two are just petty thieves. You'd steal the pearls off your own grandmother if you had the chance.
Hey, now that's not entirely true.
The point is, I have a gun. And I have more men with more guns, and that makes me stronger. Now, I knew you boys would have a hell of a time repaying me, but I thought, call it charity, call it a gift. I don't give a shit. If I don't return a profit, I put survival at risk. Now, I'm not a good loser. If I go, you're coming too. I'm the lion, and you're the antelope. If I have to kill you to survive, I will do it in 1 second. You understand?
Which one of us is the lion and the antelope again?
If you don't give me the $10,000 by tomorrow, I'll kill both of you. Is that more clear? Pleasure doing business with you boys.
Pleasure's all mine.
Hey, Lawrence!
That's Lawrence. Although he hates the name, he's our fence. That is to say, you steal it, he sells it.
That's quite a pickle you guys got yourself into.
We're just wondering if we could just borrow $10,000, Lawrence.
Hey, I told you. Call me L. And, I don't really have much to spare cash-wise at the moment.
You mean you're broke?
No, of course not. I'm good for it. It's just, my finances are tied up in certain liquid assets.
You're broke, Lawrence.
So what? You've got nothing.
Look, man, it's a lot of cash to move in one night.
Without us, you'd be nothing. You gotta know of something.
I may have something. Something small, alright? But it's all I got. You guys know Rod Fernstein? Well, he's this guy, this big shot from Chicago. Looks like a movie villain from a movie in 1982. Anyway, big smiling, striving businessman to the public eye, of course, right? But this guy, he's been distributing to made men for some time now. He's a drug lord, he's a top player.
Fast forward, excuse me, but we're kind of on a time limit here.
Meth is moving into the big cities, all right? Labs are popping up all over the place, you know? They're buying, except the guys he's bringing in, they don't have the experience that the cookers around here have had, so he's buying up supplies. Well, situation like this, 10 grand is small bills. There's one going down tonight. I have an associate who is red-faced because it means he's going to be out of stock.
That doesn't make sense, because we don't deal in that kind of stuff.
But we are pretty good at getting in the middle of these kinds of situations.
It's a long shot, at best.
Oh, dude. And then we could just steal the money out from under them and they wouldn't even know who took it.
Oh my god. Come on, we're burning time, Lawrence. L, we need that address.
It was a small chance, but still a chance.
Alright, it's been 40 minutes. I think we missed the man.
Keep your eyes peeled. We can wait all night if we have to.
Wait. I see something.
And there it was. Salvation.
What do you think is in that case?
Hopefully enough.
All right. We do it like we did in Branson. But I got shot in Branson.
I thought we agreed on 50.
Mr. Fernstein does not like to deal in upfront payments. You receive the rest of your money when the supply is delivered.
Snatch and grabs are about as simple as you can get. A little misdirection and you're golden. A bit dangerous with people who drink cough syrup like it's water, but I'd rather risk getting shot up over whatever Dermot had in mind.
Oh, I'm sorry, I don't want any trouble. It just seems that Old Faithful ran out of gas on me. Must be that inconsistent fuel gauge or something. I could, maybe fill up my tank? Heck, I'd pay for it.
No, we don't have gas here.
Ah, ducks. I'll just call my brother, he's a cop.
No. No cops. We have gas. Please come with me.
Perfect.
That's not what we agreed to. You can make more than that, bump.
Body and the blood and everything, we gotta get right over here. I think I don't
want to be killed. He's
fucked out. I told you, he's right up here.
Oh shit, we gotta Go.
Oh, there he is!
Oh, God,
there he is!
We gotta go!
They're shooting
us!
There are moments in your life that are turning points. This was one of those.
There's enough green in there for Dermot and then some.
You guys really did it.
We'll contact Dermot's men tomorrow. Arrange a drop.
I can't believe you sons of bitches actually pulled it off.
I want to get some sleep.
Put the money away.
I would be lying if I said I didn't feel relieved. We did the impossible. With some luck, we'd be alive by this time tomorrow. It was the high point of that whole year.
What the hell are you doing?
Let's not get ahead of ourselves.
Hey guys, what's happening?
I was just on my way out.
You're fingering us, aren't you?
What?
No, no, like a finger, like you steal from someone. It's a phrase. People use it.
That money is the only thing standing in the way of a bullet getting shot in my face.
Hey, look, I don't want it to be this way, all right? I don't.
All right, but you're right. I'm broke. All right, I have no money. I'm barely staying afloat here, and I have my own debts to pay off. I never thought you'd get the money, and it's... This is my only chance.
Dermot is gonna kill us.
Reason with him. Who's ever reasoned with Dermot?
God damn it, man, you're sucking right now.
Come on, Hannah. You're my friend, Jay. All right, come on, guys. Come on. She's gotta stop being so selfish, okay? All right, I'm just looking out for number one here, same as you. Like I said, I didn't want it to be like this.
Son of a bitch!
That's probably the third worst time of my life. Betrayed. Condemned to die. It was not good. And when we thought it couldn't get much worse, it did.
Tom, I presume.
Please, I'll give you whatever you want. I know people.
I'm sure you do, Tom. I'm sure you do. Now, I'm just here to ask you a few simple questions and take up a little bit of your time. You see, I'm a businessman, not unlike yourself. You practice in a multitude of areas, right?
Sure, man. Well, whatever you need.
I'm an associate of Mr. Fairstein. Now, some money of his went missing recently. Luckily, though, computers can do anything these days, like trace serial numbers on dollar bills. You spent his money at 5:35 this morning, Tom. His money went missing 4 hours prior. Where is the money?
I don't know, man.
Don't lie to me. I'm not a hateful man, but I loathe lying.
Oh God, I don't know anything. Just let me go.
Tom. I'm sure it's just wrong place, time. We're businessmen here. We don't want to hurt you. Well, I don't.
Oh God!
Hey, eyes on me. Just tell us where the money is, and we'll be on our way. That's all we want. Don't make me ask him.
A guy named Lawrence. He's a small town fence. I don't know where he got it. He owed me money, so I don't know where he went.
That's it? Because if you're going to be uncooperative, there's other people we can ask. What's your girlfriend's name? Heather. Heather the nurse.
You know the great thing about the Midwest, Tom? No one locks up their doors.
I swear I don't know anything else. I swear. If I knew more, I would tell you.
I'm sure you would, Tom. I'm sure you would. I believe you. I really do. See, you've been a big help. We got a name. That's a great start, eh?
Wait, but...
You shouldn't have lied to me in the first place. I'm sorry.
No! Wait! No way! No!
Time wasn't on our side. Every minute gone was a minute closer to the grave.
Hi, Lawrence.
Wait, I...
Needless to say, it's easier to negotiate with a scumbag when you're the one holding a gun. Or a baseball bat. But it turns out that Lawrence had spent some of the money, probably on drugs or cheap hookers. I'm not one for burning bridges, but we had bigger fish to fry. Dermot's family owns a few of these abandoned farm sites in the area, along with a couple vacant lots.
Looks like
breaking
home.
The law is considerably easier in private.
Here we go. Yeah. Okay.
Dermot's been waiting.
We have his money.
You're late.
We had a little difficulty.
Let him know.
Something didn't feel right. There was too much money in that briefcase for Dermot not to be there personally for me to hand it to him. So, I knew what I had to do. I knew this wasn't exactly gonna be easy. But then again, when is it?
Oh, he's got a gun! He's got a gun! We gotta get out of here! Go!
Over the fence!
Come on! Just take it!
Hurry up!
Just take it!
Over!
Go!
Just go! Keep it!
That was the second worst time of my life.
Heather!
But what's so important about Tom?
All right, now look, I told you not to come to me about the...
Welcome, Lawrence.
The waiting was the worst, by far. I should have been out there. Zach could have been dead, maybe worse.
Dermot?
Hey, how are you doing?
I'm not in the mood.
Now here's what we're going to do. You give us the money, and we don't kill your brother.
It doesn't take a genius to know we both die if I give him the money.
Where do you want the money?
This whole thing went to a place that I never expected it to go. I never knew what impending doom felt like. Well, this was about it.
Fantastic.
What's happening?
You're up.
What's going on?
We're associates of Mr. Fairstein.
No.
We're businessmen, Lawrence. Men of quid pro quo. Now we just need you to answer a few very simple questions, and we'll be right on our way.
Look, I don't want any trouble, okay?
You see, I'm kind of a history buff. I especially like the Middle Ages period. You see, all the other periods are just filled with boring laws and people inventing boring devices. But the people in the Middle Ages, they were sick. You see, what they used to do, they used to take a victim and hang them upside down, splitting them directly in half.
They were sick, absolutely sick.
But you see, they were smart. Even in those live-in-the-dirt days, they knew. They knew that when they hung the victim upside down, all the blood would rush to the head, and the victim would stay awake until you hit an artery.
No.
Somewhere in the middle.
No, I'll tell you. Okay, I'll tell you everything. All right? There's these two guys, the Cooper brothers, the Jay and Zach. They stole the money. All right, they stole the money, I swear. I took some of it, all right? I had some, but I knew what they wanted to do, and I was gonna give it back, I swear, but they stole it back. Okay, they stole it back, I swear. I swear to God they did.
They're fast. We've got a smart one here.
I swear. Now they came after him though. They owed money. This scumbag Dermot. All right. I don't know where they're at. But if they're alive, they won't be for long. And he'll have your money, Dermot.
Wonderful. We'll be back in time for dinner.
Oh, thank you. Thank you.
No, I think you misunderstood me. I meant, we'll be back in time for dinner.
No, but I told you everything. I told you.
Until Jay's supposed to be here. Looks like he's not coming.
Great. He's probably halfway to Mexico right now, laughing his ass off the whole way.
That's enough. Now, if I don't see money in a minute and 35 seconds, you can kill him.
Where's Jay?
Wasn't there. Just this.
Of all the crime lord wannabes, Dermot is the only one to make his handoff spot his incredibly well-known hideout. If he wanted a fight, then I guess I was gonna give him one.
I guess we can kill him now.
And with just a couple warning shots, the party had begun.
You had the money somewhere else?
Yeah.
That's a con. A bit cliche, though.
Short notice.
Hey, let me tell you something. When we go somewhere else, when we get out of here, let's go somewhere warm, okay? Like California, maybe.
Sounds good.
And that was probably the worst time of my life.
No. Don't be hasty.
Fuck. Shoot him! He shot me in the arm!
Put the gun down, please. Just put the gun down.
You were armed. It's self-defense. I'm not a man of mindless violence. So base. I'm a businessman. An associate of Mr. Fairstein. You two look like you matched the description of the people who stole his property. He'd like it back.
Shoot him! Just wait. I'm not here for any trouble, all right? We're just gonna go on our way.
You shoot me, I make sure he dies.
All right, just wait. 1 second. Please.
How can he shoot me if you shoot him? Shoot him!
Just shut up! For like 1 second! Please!
I don't want any more blood to be spilt here. I'm a reasonable guy. I'm not a monster. Just tell me what I want to know, Zach. Please.
Please.
You remember Pensacola?
Yeah. Gentlemen, I'm a man of little patience.
I suggest that you tell me where the money is.
Good shot.
I had my eyes closed the whole time. Let's go.
Just keep going.
I can't go any longer. How many people are trying to kill us, Jack? Oh, no!
Let's get out of here. Before one of the sons of bitches comes back.
I remember thinking how terrible it was that this is how our illustrious career ends. I also wondered if being the last to die counted as survival of the fittest. Then I remembered, we have a plastic bag full of cash waiting for us.
Get up.
5 more minutes.
We're not dying here. Not today. They say old habits die hard. There was no telling how far we'd go with that kind of currency. Then again.
Go!
We were never very good with money.
I know you're dead!